Here's the bottom line. The more patient player usually wins. In this video, we're going to explain the power of patience in Smash and fighting games, and we're gonna do it quickly for the sake of all those impatient people out there. We're gonna break it down into three parts. Why patience matters, what patience in Smash looks like, and why we aren't patient, and how to practice and build patience. Briefly, if you're looking for something else to make your Smash game stronger, try ProGuides.com. We have a lot of resources on our site, including coaches, lessons from pros, and more. And one final thing before we start, our question of the day. What is the first thing that comes to your mind when you think about Smash Ultimate? Go now! To the comments! Act fast and irrational before we teach you how to slow things down. If you wonder why patience matters, think about Rock, Paper, Scissors. This simple game you learned as a kid is in a ton of games you play now. Fire Emblem Weapon Triangle, Rock, Paper, Scissors. Tank Assassin DPS in a MOBA, Rock, Paper, Scissors. Shield Attack, Grab, and Smash? You get the picture. In Rock, Paper, Scissors, both players throw their option at the same time. In fighting games, one player often throws theirs first. So, if you were playing Rock, Paper, Scissors and you saw someone throw scissors, you'd throw rock. If you see someone with a shield grab, you'd attack. In fighting games, if you're patient, you can wait for someone to throw rock, letting you know to throw paper. Sometimes, they'll even tell you they're gonna throw rock.
Wanna tell them what you're gonna go?
Hey, I think they did.
Wait a minute. Say whatever you want. I can't interrupt banter.
Hey, I'm going rock.
You went rock, man! Hang on!
If you're not patient, you'll probably end up throwing an option out of nowhere and losing. If you're really, really skeptical, you can find tons of top competitors who lost due to impatience. Even the fan-favorite hyper-aggressive pro players often adopt a patient style. Patience isn't a style, it's a skill. Lower-level players approach too much, and in predictable, punishable ways. Dash attacking or grabbing at the lowest level, then full-hop aerials, then short-hop aerials, then cross-ups. Gradually less punishable approaches, but still punishable. Low-level players just want to land a hit. Low-level players are impatient. Even the best players have moments of impatience. Low-level players just have them more often. The real question is, why we get impatient in the first place? Part of the answer is expectation. We come into fighting games with a false expectation that the game is about fighting. In reality, it's more about decision-making. But decision-making games doesn't sound as good as fighting games. Plus, people would think you're pretty odd for calling Smash a decision-making game when Mario's right there punching someone to death. I mean, maybe some decision-making led him down this path, but I don't know about you, but that's not really the most profound thing I've ever bared witness to, but hey, that's just me. However, a great deal of any fighting game isn't spent trading blows. It's spent getting an opening. A lot of players come into fighting games expecting that you win by landing more hits than the opponent. But the winner isn't always the one who lands more hits. Just ask a Ganon main. The winner is the one who makes the better decisions. Expectation influences our patience. When we expect we'll have to wait to get something, it's much easier to be patient. This is true for simple short-term things like making a meal, or complex long-term things like waiting for a paycheck or a game release. We've scientifically observed and cataloged the effect of expectation on patience. Well, in mice at least. A recent study rewarded mice for poking a button with their nose. One group of mice got a reward 75% of the time they pushed the button, where two other groups got a reward 50% and 25% of the time. Within the groups, they mixed up the timing of the reward as well, giving a treat at a precise second count and a random second count. The scientists were testing expectations. With a 75% chance of reward and the reward delivered on time, the mice could reasonably expect a certain outcome. The mice in the consistent 75% punctual reward group had increased serotonin levels. Serotonin is a chemical in the brain that does a ton of stuff like regulate your mood, depression, and anxiety. Add all of this together, and what we see is the mice's brain becomes more patient and regulated if it expects that patience will be rewarded. While the test is in mice and not humans, mice are test animals in part because their brains share similarities to ours. Evolutionarily speaking, it makes sense we'd share this pattern with mice. Our brains want to reward us for waiting for reliable sources of food and water. Societally, we see the effect of expectation on patients pretty much everywhere. If there's a 30-minute wait for food at a nice restaurant, you won't mind. If there's a 30-minute wait for food at Wendy's, you might get impatient. This is expectation. We call it fast food for a reason. It's also why many gamers can wait 4 years for a game, but lose their minds once it gets delayed 4 months. It all boils down to this point. We expect Smash to be a fast-paced brawl. We expect to land hits in a fighting game. We expect the good game of Smash to be fast like Fatality versus Runes. In reality, the game is more consistently T versus Mars than it is Fatality versus Runes. You can dislike long matches and call them campy, but that'll just set you back in the long run. It poisons your expectations, and that in turn poisons your patience. Instead, change your expectations of competitive play. Know that most of the time, it doesn't look like a quick play highlight reel. Most of the time, a top 10 player is too patient to let you style on them. And if you try it, they'll probably reversal you. Remember, you aren't actually fighting in these fighting games. You're making decisions. And patient decisions are almost always better than rushed ones. Now that we know why patience is important and why we often lack it, it's time to build patience. Despite our brain's best efforts, patience doesn't always come naturally. In panic situations, threat situations, and unpredictable situations, our patience can quickly erode. Sometimes we're forced to make quick decisions, and in those moments, it's hard to be patient and calm. Sometimes Smash is so unpredictable that it's not clear we're being rewarded for patience. We get frustrated and rush in. To build patience, we first need to temper our expectations. We need to understand that Smash is a patient man's game. All fighting games are. Hungrybox dominates Melee with patience. Goichi dominates Dragon Ball FighterZ with patience, and so on. It's baked into the rock-paper-scissors design they all share. To reset expectations, try not to visualize your games as stomps and highlight reels. Try to visualize your games as calm and calculated. As you watching the opponent and picking the right option over and over again. Our visualizations set our expectations for the best case scenario in game. And in your super close competitive games, your best case scenario probably won't look like the 64 combo contest. Second, we need to understand when it's our turn to play. This is a super common phrase in fighting games, but less common in Smash. It's your turn to play when you escape disadvantage. When you're done blocking, dodging, and getting back to stage. You need to know what your character can do and how their matchups work. In some matchups, it'll be your turn quickly. Some characters can't pressure you well off stage or on the ledge. Others can. At high levels, this is why we see a lot of rinse and repeat edgeguards that build damage but don't kill. Both players understand whether or not it's their turn, and they're being patient. When you haven't reset neutral, it's not your turn. Stay patient. Focus on dodging and blocking, then take your turn. Third, look at the clock. Smash is a time game, and it always has been. Well, almost always. By checking the clock, you can get a realistic idea of how rushed you actually are. It's fine to not close a single stock until 4 minutes in. Even these games often don't go to timeout. A quick glance at the clock can ground your mentality and remind you that you don't need to rush it. Fourth and finally, practice your patience in training mode. Go into training mode, pick any character, maybe a character you struggle with. Set them to level 9, then let the CPU take over. Now move into their threat range and focus on staying within that threat range while dodging their attacks. Do not counter hit, just dodge. You want to try and stay within threat range because dodging inside threat range often yields the best punishes. If you find the level 9 isn't approaching enough, turn them down to level 7. If you watched our shadowboxing video, this may sound familiar. It's a shadowboxing exercise, and a good one. It'll level up your defense and patience. You can start this drill at 30 seconds and increase time gradually to build patience. You can also start adding counter hits after your dodging period is done. This will help you understand when it is and isn't your turn and what your punish options look like. Since Smash isn't literally rock, paper, scissors, you have to learn which options beat which. This exercise will help you do that. To recap, the patient player usually wins because they see and react to the first mover's option. We're impatient because we don't expect Smash to be a patient game and don't always see the rewards for patience. We can build our patience by 1. Changing our expectations and visualizations, 2. Understanding when it's our turn, 3. Looking at the clock, and 4. Shadowboxing the CPU while focusing on not getting hit. Build up your patience and you'll probably build up your skill too. If you want other tips, tricks, and lessons on how to get better, check out our website. We've got great courses from pro players as well as a live coaching platform. Thanks for watching patiently all the way to the end.